analysis method of choice.
Jetzt also.
Welcome to the Chromatography Experts broadcast. In this series of video, we'll explain some separation techniques and methods. My name is Romain Dabre, and I'm a product manager at Tosoh Bioscience. Together with my colleague, Patrick Andres, we plan to film out of Tosoh's lab in Griesheim, Germany. But due to the current situation, we decided to move on with an home office edition focused on light scattering detection. So first things first, what is light scattering?
So in light scattering, we have one laser that points directly on the flow cell, and then around the flow cell, we got our detectors, and they are positioned at different angles to see the scattered light that is scattered by the sample that flows through the flow cell at different angles. And then from the position of these angles, we can do various assumptions or calculations about the molecules that flow through the flow cell. And the first principle is that the amount of scattered light that is re-emitted by each molecule is directly related to the size of the molecule. This means the bigger the molecule is, the more light is scattered by it. And the second principle is that the amount of the scattered light from each individual molecule differs in the directions.
Then I am wondering why someone would use light scattering for the characterization of biomolecules.
So the main advantage of light scattering is that you get the information about the molecular weight and size or ratio of gyration of your molecule without the need for external calibration or reference molecules. So if you develop completely new molecules, let's say for example pegylated proteins or completely new polymers, and you have no idea about the rough shape or size, size exclusion chromatography coupled with multi-angle light scattering would be the analysis method of choice.
What are the main challenges encountered during the analysis of biomolecules using MALS SEC?
The main challenge when using size exclusion chromatography coupled with multi-angle light scattering is the signal-to-noise ratio. And most of the times it's not really the signal that's the issue, it's the noise. So everything really in the system produces some kind of noise. It can be the HPLC itself, the columns sheds a few particles, our mobile phase is not 100% pure, and all of this creates some noise. But also the detectors are sometimes very sensitive to noise, especially if we go to the very low and very high angles. Another issue with multi-angle light scattering is that basically all the data that we are shown by the evaluation software is based on an assumption, or it's based on the simplot, which is basically an extrapolation of all the data that we use, and the data is then extrapolated to 180 and 0 degrees, and from this extrapolation we calculate all our results. So in the end it's not really a measured result, but it's a calculated result by an extrapolation.
At Tosoh, we introduced a new MALS detector recently called LenS3. This detector tackles the challenges you presented before. Could you explain how?
Yeah, so as I said before, the main issue really is the noise of the detector. So this is the point that we tackled the most. And we did this by completely redesigning and rethinking light scattering. So instead of a glass flow cell, we use a black peak flow cell. And this flow cell only lets the light out at 10 degrees, 90 degrees, and 170 degrees. And this is exactly the angles where we are measuring the stray light. And this also allows us to use a green laser compared to the conventionally used red laser. And the green laser has the advantage that we can generate approximately 3 times more signal compared to the red laser. I mean, of course, you could also use a green laser with the conventionally or currently available detectors, but this also increases the noise by a factor of 3, so your signal to noise is not improved. And additionally, we also, as I already mentioned, we have the angles at 10, 90 and 170 degrees, and this allows us to really do a direct measurement of the molecular weight and also a direct calculation of the rates of gyration without the need of the simplot. And the simplot, as I said before, is this extrapolation. And all in all, these improvements really allow us to measure, for example, monoclonal antibody monoclonal antibodies down to injection mass of 2 nanograms and to measure any molecule with the radius of gyration down to 2 nanometers.
Thanks, Patrick. If you are interested in knowing more about the new LenS3 MALS detector, follow the link in the description of this video or reach out to your usual Tosoh contact. Thanks for watching.